Welcome back to Land House. I know last week's vlog was all about lack of sleep and getting to meet baby Emma, but let's change that. This week should be all about enjoying the time we have with Emma. Actually, I just took about an hour-long nap with her, so it's good. Can you believe from this view right here that we just got 3 inches of snow last night? It's hot now, and it's melted really fast. Like, you can see some left over there, and the water's definitely dripping off the workshop here, but it's gone fast. So I was realizing that I don't always give credit where credit is due. I received a comment saying that not sure about what model reciprocating saw I have, but some of them, instead of a twisting handle, you just position the blade in the different spots. And that comment was from Tolman, I believe is how you pronounce it. So anyway, I'm going to try and get credit where credit is due more often. So if you write in something that helps with whatever I'm doing, I will attempt to mention you. So anyway, let's go check out that reciprocating saw again and see if he is right here. Oh. Because that would be cool. Well, let's see. It looks like that just has a single position, straight up and down. Yeah, that's all we got in there. So my guess, I'm just going to finally put this to rest, that this saw only operates in one direction. My dad stopped by yesterday to hold Emma and also brought by some of the packages that were delivered. And I wanted to show you what came in here. So this is the first work light that I was talking about in the previous video. You can see it's 9 by 9, just about. And what was it, 76 watts on there? Anyway, replaces a 300 watt, so that's huge. Should be quite exciting to test out. This was the other one. The picture's not as awesome, but the LED is down here in the bottom, and it's a 30 watt, so it should be lots of fun to try out. More ram pump stuff. Last week's ram pump sales were great. Definitely kicking the season back off. Let's see. I got these solar lights in. Now, I've been denying a lot of solar lights because I really have reviewed tons of them. But I got these for the ability to put on... Well, let me just open it up and show you real quick. What I thought they were sending me was a light that detached from the solar panel that you could stretch up and, like, you know, put one side on the roof and one side where it's dark. But they did not send the extension cable. So I'm going to write them back real quick and see if they'll send that. If they don't, I'll probably buy it anyway because I want to have one light on the back of the house so that it's motion detecting. So that's going to be a test, and then the other one they sent is the same thing, but this will be in an upcoming giveaway. So, just to give you a heads up, that's a giveaway, and then this one, which is coming out Monday, I think. So you'll have already seen this review by the time this video comes out, but this is also going to be a giveaway, and this is a really fun light that's going to be coming out, so... Look forward to those giveaways. Let's see what else. Oh, this one. This company contacted me and said, we have professional surveying equipment we'd like you to use on your job sites. Well, I don't really have job sites, just the workshop here and around the building. So they sent this. It's really the only thing on their site that I could use because I'm not a surveyor. This is just a level, but it has a tripod and a case and all this cool stuff. And it's a cross level. So my thoughts are, whenever it's time to install like shelving or especially the French cleat system, it will throw up a level line and a cross beam, and I'll know where to install stuff. So, and my thoughts were too, since my studs are straight up and down, what I can do is when I put up like a panel, I can use that cross laser and it'll draw the line of where my stud is in there. So I can just go up the line and put my screws instead of the guesswork. Like, for instance, guesswork right happened right there and I had to come back over and do that. So it'll be helpful in both inside and outside. So anyway, I'll be doing a review with this laser pretty soon, and I think it'll make things a bit easier here in the workshop. Weather sure has been weird this time of year. So I've got a couple things planned for today, depending on how Emma is and how Ashley's doing with her. But I'm dragging some more garden hose because about a year ago, I started filming a video of installing some water tanks up here for the garden. And I messed up. I didn't use the right size hole saw. And so I never did finish the video. But I thought today was a perfect day to play in the water, obviously. And so I'm using this garden hose to fill the tanks up here. And when I shot the video last year, man, I looked a lot different back then. Remember those old shirts, Special Olympic shirts? Yeah. Anyway, the other project I want to do today is film the review of that workshop light. And so I'll have to go to the store and buy a couple of boxes for that because I don't have them. But it should be a pretty good day. I figure if I get two projects done, I will feel accomplished for the day. I have some exciting news. Land House finally broke down and bought the vlogging camera for Ashley. This year I've had to pay taxes on my self-employment, and that's been no fun. And so my tax preparer has suggested that I buy more stuff for video-related things. And so the two cameras that I want to buy, the one I just got for her and then one for me, the Canon G7X Mark II, should help out with next year's tax issues. And also, the other thing I want to buy this year is a video card for my computer. It has a hard time with more than one layer. I hope you can hear, the wind is terrible. It has a hard time with more than one layer of HD video. I mean, it's, gosh, 6 years old or better. So those are my purchases with Land a House YouTube this year. So that should be good. So I'm heading down to turn on the ram pump for the storage tank project that I'm doing. I may have just mentioned that. But I wanted to talk about the Wrangler Star clickbait video. Way more response than I was expecting. It took me 3 days to respond to the first round of comments, which is fun. Uh-oh. My lawnmower shed fell down. I'll have to come over here and tie that back up. This lasted, what, 2 years at least? But it was fun getting to hear the various degrees of tolerance on clickbait titles, ranging from I don't care to I unsubscribed because I can't stand those titles. So anyway, it was fun to get a different set of opinions on the same topic. So thank you so much for being involved in that. Snowed a lot last night. Mostly melted now though. It's just cold. About 29 degrees, I think is the high today.
You can probably see my breath a little bit. So I'm about to film the video of the workshop light that's going to go right here in the middle. And to get that ready to film, I'm going to install, of course, the wire, which we've been doing, and then the board that's going to go across here for the support of that light. So I just cut a 2x4 there, and now I'm going to measure out the middle of this section here to put the light in. So that's what I'm doing currently. I just finished getting that 76 watt LED canopy light installed. Shabam, so bright. So let me show you how bright it is in here with all the lights on. So there's the old set, and then the set over here. So, as you can see, nice and bright in here. Now that I do have this one last light to test out from the same company, and that I'm gonna put probably another piece right over there. Doop. And it's gonna point down here, because eventually I'm gonna have my built-in workbench gonna be 10 foot right along this edge here. And I'm probably gonna end up doing all of my French cleat on this side. And that way, over here, and this table won't be here, but this side will be where I roll my carts of tools. Like this will be on a cart, that'll be on a cart, and I'll have a table saw that'll roll up in here. So it'll just be a storage in there where tools just go against the wall. And then, of course, a computer over there, and storage for something over there that I'll get into later. And I do like the idea that my parents have at their shop, where along the border of like a couple walls maybe, like do a shelf maybe at 8 foot up there. I could probably use this table as one of those shelf pieces. So it'll just be storage up high for stuff I don't use very often. Let's see. Oh yeah. So I was running out of these ram pump parts pretty quick here. So bought some more. Those are the half inch closed razors and the 3/4 inch. So yeah, getting ready for lots of ram pumps to go out. I'll make sure I have enough stuff for it all.
Well, I believe that's going to conclude this week's Land House vlog. I hope you have enjoyed watching. Next week, I'm sure we'll get into a lot more fun stuff. At least I hope so. I'm really looking forward to bringing you along with that new Canon camera that I'm getting for Ashley that I'm going to be testing out. So the quality should improve drastically. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next video.